Good morning. This is the continuation of whatever that coverage that we were doing in the last class. After the internal exam one, we discussed the solution also, and we evaluated all the things. Some of you might not have received the IA marks, but others have received. I'll send the list copy of that one by today evening to you all people, right? But one, the thing, important thing which I was seeing in your answer is that the requirement specification is not written properly by majority of you. Okay, though I have considered and given a few marks for that, but it is not to the my expectations how requirements are to be written. Right? Look at the few examples. Okay, given in our Google class, please refer it to that. Right? Now, continuation of that, we are in the third unit. Right? Please look into that on Friday afternoon. UI design related things. There is a session. You need to attend that. This is the one which you are seeing here, right? The yellow mark you can see, right? Already we have gone through the UI, a few examples and all, what is good, what is bad, and all the things. But on that day, things will be covered, right? Then maybe from the next class, I'll get into agile method and other aspect of this legacy system. They're all small, simple, and all. Extreme programming terms and all. Okay, we will go through few aspect of these things which can be covered in just one or two classes. We will get into that, right? But what is important is architectural design, right? Architectural design that we will see now, right? Already we are gone through that one. We'll continue doing that. Is it okay, Ashish?
Yeah, yes, sir.
Right. So what is that we have seen in the last class? Okay, is about the advantage of using this developing software architecture. Then we are seeing some of the things, right? Ashish, have you updated our question bank?
Sir, in my absence, Arpita must have done it.
Just check it. Ask Arpita, and I asked a few things to note down. Okay, check it whether it has been done or not. Arpita, are you listening here? Okay, please contact her. Right.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, the architecture of an integrated case tool set, right, we have discussed, right? Maybe film and picture library system, when we talk about that, this is again speak about the various components, okay, catalog server, video server, this also we have discussed. Layered architecture, we discussed the advantage of layered architecture. Okay, it helps in code maintenance, right? Because anything in a particular layer, you do the change, the impact of the change we call ripple, that is within this particular layer only. That is the advantage of abstraction in object orientation. Got it? The abstract class, the abstraction or encapsulation. The benefit of an encapsulation is, right, code maintenance, design maintenance. Right? It will help you to restrict the impact of the change within that particular class only. That is advantage of encapsulation. Please mute all. Right. That is advantage of you going for encapsulation. I discussed that in the previous class. Right? And we talked about the object model or the class model. I gave an example of this particular thing. We discussed about that, right? So now look at that. The question you may get for which the solution is this. It is required to develop a software which allows the user to draw the right various shapes and all. Shapes include polygon, circles, spline, arc, line, point, etc. And these are grouped in zero dimensional, one dimensional, two dimensional kind of things, right? And all these diagrams are to be displayed. Then you can rotate this one, you can select these things, you can move around that. And each diagram, they have got color, their position, their thickness, their pen type, etc. Right? Every diagram henceforth, whatever that you add it to this list and all, will have the properties, essential properties, mandatory properties, and all these things. Right? So if the problem description goes like this, this is a solution. Right? And also we discussed about that one, the use of an abstract class. What is an abstract class is different. What is the use of an abstract class is different. That also we have discussed. Okay, please, okay, look into those aspects of learning. Right? Yes. I'm telling what is that we have done in the last class. Then we said about the pipeline model of this push and pull model. I gave an example of Lex and Act tool, okay, and the program in that YYLex, lex.yy.c, okay, all the things, yak, okay, y.tab.c, okay, yyparse, these are the different functions and all, but how do they coordinate? And there I told that when a token is being formed, a token is the smallest unit of any programming language, recognizable unit of any, okay, of the programming language, right? When you are forming some of the character ahead of time, you okay take it from the buffer, okay, check it that token is formed or not, and then later you push it back. So the push and pull model of a pipeline architecture, that also we have discussed. Please remember that. Okay, Ashish, right, explain the push and pull model of pipeline model of system architecture, right? Compiler is the best example. We referred that also. Please refer the video. Right now, the new thing today, okay, that what your textbooks speak all about is a call and return model, right? So you will have okay, in any program you will have different modules, you have a recursions and all, right? How exactly a routine calls another routine and return kind of things, right? This is basically helpful in understanding, right, which module, which function calls the other one and how do they return. This is particularly useful in recursions and all, right? Now look at that. Okay, you can, including the parameter, whatever that you pass, A is an array, N is a number of parameters, right? Read number will read, okay, N number of integer element or could be any other thing and put it in an array, and that's being passed to the main program. The main program takes that A and N, pass it to sort, and you get a sorted array, right? Then in order to sort that one, you have something called like a switch module, okay, whatever that is there, swapping kind of things that's being done here, right? Then finally, you call add N, which will take A and N, which is, okay, this, and it will sum it and give to you. Sorting is different, summing is different, right? So you understand that one, what kind of an exchange of, exchange in the form of a call and return things are happening in a given things, okay, you understand it. This is the one perspective of understanding the whole system, right? Arpita and Ashish, is it okay? Call and return model. What is the use of call and return model? Illustrate with an example. Ashish, Nodam. Right? Then another example is, right, explain the push and pull model, okay, using Lex and Act examples. Ashish, are you listening?
Yes, sir.
Right. Then another one is, okay, you will be given a description, problem description of half a page. You will be asked to construct a class diagram, which is a UML diagram, right? When I talk about the class diagram, okay, please refer this. This is the best example for the class diagram, right? And problem description already I told. You can take a screenshot of this also, right? You are asked to develop a software which allow the user to draw the different diagrams, which include point, line, arc, spline, polygon, circle. They have been grouped into zero dimensional, one dimensional, two dimensional. All, okay, shapes, they have a mandatory requirement of moving around the screen, selecting the screen by the user, rotating that one and displaying on the screen. And they have an attribute like a color, center position, pen thickness, pen type, etc. Right? So draw the class diagram for this. Right? Now look at this arrow mark here, whatever you're using, it is for the inheritance. Right? Yes. Is it okay? Ashish?
Yes, sir.
I told you the problem, possible problem statement and possible solutions. Though the problem description is half a page or a page, but solution is simple. Right? Please understand that. Right? So, now I'll move to the routine kind of things. Right. Call and return model, I said. Now, interrupt-driven control model. In computer organization, you might have, okay, got it. So there is something called an interrupt vector. It reminds me of my final year BE project. I did it on interrupt controller, a program, system development on interrupt controller, right? So every interrupt has its own vector where in that location, look at this in the cursor, there the address of the routine to be executed, they are called interrupt handler, interrupt service routine, ISR. Let me write on using a pen, right? They are called interrupt service routine. This ISR addresses are stored here. Here ISR, here ISR, here ISR, here ISR. Okay, best example is whenever you press a key on the keyboard, you know, the keyboard interrupt will raise, and whatever that you type, your appropriate handler will read that one and display on the screen. Are you getting it? Right? And the routine, these handlers are called interrupt service routines, and their addresses are being stored here. Is that clear? Is that clear? Hello, Ashish, Arpita, Ashish Narayan K.
Yes.
Yeah, right. That's good. Right? Then this ISM model in network, you might have seen, it is a layered architecture. The advantage of the layered architecture, already we have told. I'm not studying, I'm making you to study the computer network here. See, just to refer it, what I told, about the layer, right, is that this is an encapsulation. This is the encapsulation. So the packet from this will come here, right? Maybe a send, and there will be acknowledgement here, right? As long as these interfaces, whatever I'm marking, they are same, anything that you change within this, right, doesn't affect the upper layer sitting on the top of that or the layer sitting at the bottom of that, right? And that is called, that is advantage of encapsulation. It will enhance code and design maintainability. Arpita, Ashish, is it clear? What are the advantage of layered architecture? Right?
Yes, sir.
Right, that's good. Right. Now, with that, we come to the end of whatever the textbook version is there, right? Then we'll get into the agile practice in the next class. Now, look at the sum of the textbook version. Please solve the examples given at the end of the textbook. Somerville, right? Pressman is also one good book, right? See here, let's get into few things. Explain why it is necessary to design the system architecture before the specifications are written. Why? Why? Right? You build overall concept. You build how, what all the system, what all the subsystem that makes a system. You try to understand the concepts and all, right? So that it becomes a very easy for architect. It becomes very easy for the analyst, so that you can communicate with the customers, client better. And that's what is being said here. Look at that. Right? Right? Stakeholder communication, you can do better communication. You can perform better system analysis. Right? You can use large scale reuse also when you go for the architecture. Right? Why this large scale reuse? That one we will see it through example. Right? Probably one session we'll arrange it where I'll call Rashmi Atinikar and give a session on that particular thing. Right? So architecture, I'll give an example later, but I'll come to the normal coverage. Then we'll have a session like user interface, whatever the session we are arranging for you on Friday, where everyone has to attend. A person from Akamai, right? He's the architect, working in network. He's going to talk about the user interface and user experience, software engineering related things. Everyone must attend that. And there will be a test immediately after that. Right? We will conduct a test immediately after the next day. Now look at this. The other set of questions, there sounds good. Explain why design conflict might arise when designing an architecture where availability and security requirements are the most important functional requirement. Oh, what answer to be written? Design conflicts. Why? In the sense, you may have a different alternative, designs architecture available for this availability. right? What is availability? Availability is to ensure that the service is round the clock that is available, right? Now, what are the design alternatives available for the availability, right? Redundancy, they're parallelly executing that. Active redundancy and passive redundancy, we talk about that. Should I go for active redundancy? Should I go for the passive redundancy? Right? For that, you need to have a redundant servers available. Okay? You have a mirroring of that, you'll do it. Right? You wanted a full service available round the clock without loss of a single thing, then you have to go for the full redundancy. Right? I think for this, we will have one case study. We will deal with that. Okay, we will get into how exactly the log files are being built, right, for Oracle. We take Oracle as an example and we'll try to deal with that. Ashish, you remind me, send a WhatsApp message to that one, a case study in Oracle architecture to look into the availability. Okay, this you send it so that in the next class immediately I will do on that.
Yeah, so, yes, sir.
Right, understood. So should I go for active redundancy? Should I go for passive redundancy? That kind of design conflict will be there, right? Please look into that. Got it, right? Security, what level of security that is required? A simple example, right? You have a username and password, right? Then sometimes you get a message from the Google saying that one press Y or no in your mobile, am I right? When you are getting into your email, right? Sometimes, okay, payment and all, you get an OTP and all. Are you getting it? Ashish, Harpita?
Yeah, yes.
Yeah, okay, then what is the kind of a conflict that you get into? Conflict is that for everything you need to pay, right? So there will be a lot of additional, okay, design and coding will be involved into that one. And people, a customer may say that one, no, I'm not interested in this. Why did you do that? Right? Okay. Now you have a design level security while providing that one. Maybe among the team members also you may have a conflicts. Right? Please go through the textbook. Right? Right. This is about this. Now let's look into the third one. I'm telling the things given at the end of the chapter, they are very interesting one. And if you don't understand thoroughly, it becomes very difficult to answer this because answer they are not available directly in the answer. I mean textbook. Construct a table showing the advantage and disadvantage of structural models discussed in this chapter. Structural model, right? So when you talk about the structural model, where all things we have covered, right? Look at that, right? It speaks about the structure, right? Are you getting it? So, right, in architecture, now, okay, where, right, we talk about the structure of the system which you are going to build, right? Okay, we all speak about the structures, right? Class diagram is the best example for structure, right? Architecture diagram is the best example for the structure. Right? Structure of the product. Now look at this. Right? Give a reason for your answer. Suggest an appropriate structural model for the following. Structural model is you can go for a class diagram. Right? You can go for data flow diagrams. That is also speaks about the structure of the things. Right? An automated ticket issuing system used by passengers at a railway station. Right? A computer controlled. I mean, what kind of model you go for? Right? Probably when you see the early part of that, let me take you into the system models. Let me take you to that. We have different models. Just a minute. Please recollect all the things. Whatever that you are seeing on the screen. That will help you in recollecting so many things. Yeah. Testing already we have introduced, which will begin soon. This particular model will speak about that as an example case study. Structural perspective. Look at that. See, when you build a model, the model could be something behavioral model. You go for the state diagram. Right? Now look at the structural perspective, where an architecture of the system or the structure of the data processed by the system is modeled. Structure of the data processed by the system is data flow diagram. That structural model, in that you talk about the data models. Data model seen in the form of how data is being processed by the system. Structure of data processed by the system. Architecture, what all the component that makes a system. Class diagram, what all the different micro level objects that makes a system. Structural perspective. Right? See, when you read a question, right, you should be in the position to correlate all these things and prepare the answer. Simply by reading the book, you will not get it. Ashish, am I right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, please look into that. Right? Data flow model, system model, when we talk about that, data flow model, composition model, architectural model, classification model, stimulus response model. Stimulus response is also call and return model, so you can put into that. Stimulus response model, you can see the transition diagram or the state diagram, whatever you have studied in the FFL model, FFL course. Right? So please go through the textbook, right, and accordingly keep yourself ready. Right? I'll simply keep moving. We'll go to the point where we are stopped and then continue from that. Yeah. Yeah. Now look at the 11.5. Design an architecture for the above system based on your choice of model. Make a reasonable assumption about the system requirement. How to write the answer? A robot floor cleaner that is intended to clean relatively clear space such as corridors. The cleaner must be able to sense walls and other obstructions. How do you build architecture? Right? You have to go for the architectural model. How do you go for that? Look at that. Very nice description. A real-time system usually uses event-driven model, event-driven model of controls. Under what circumstance would you recommend use of call return control model of a real-time system? Give a reason for your answer. Suggest an appropriate control model. A television, sorry, discuss the advantage you get with it. Right? So this is a kind of a very vague question for which how well you write the answer. And when question is asked for 5 marks, you may get 1 mark to 5 marks. It is not dependent on number of pages you write it. How appropriate you are, your common sense. Right? Please read the textbook thoroughly. Right? Then, data flow pipes and filters we discussed. It is taken from other books, so simply I'll scan through. Layered architecture visualization. I'll skip this case study. We go for the use case model also, right? The purpose of the use case, right? Now, what is the purpose of the use case? It is about the functionality, right? Please look into this. Here, the example, okay? Here, most important functional requirements, right? Functionality, when you talk about that, you go for the use case model. Use case model functionality. You have a decision table, input events, output, and process activation. We have seen it. Here it is being represented in different way. Data flow, I mean, a decision table. is another things, okay, which speaks about, right, the event that occurs and the action that is taken. Event action model that is being captured in the what you can say, the decision tables. Data flow model. I will not get into the details of this. Class diagram, right? So this is, okay, what we were talking to you all about the architecture, right? So let me go back to your syllabus. We were talking about this. Object-oriented design, already we have discussed that as a part of your Java programming workshop, whatever we've been done, first few hours of session, I've done it. Right, I will not repeat that. So UI design, few examples we have quoted, and further on Friday we are going to discuss. Right, from day after tomorrow, we will begin with the agile practice, extreme programming. All right, and some of the terms like legacy systems and all these things, and we will keep moving towards the completion of the third unit by end of this week. Right. Then about the testing, little bit we introduced about that, right, when we have gone through the sequence diagram, we recollect it, and further we get into different techniques of testing, right? The different techniques of testing that includes here, right, equivalence partitioning, boundary value analysis, cause-effect graphing, right, test generation from predicates, statement testing, branch testing, condition testing, path testing, okay, data flow testing. These are all, right, specific things which will take more time, right? Definitely more than 2 weeks. We'll cover all these things. These are all the specific where practiced one, okay, you will get it. And already we have asked you to develop one model-based testing, okay, as assignment where you will be writing a program for the stack based on the state diagram, and you will be creating the test script for that also. That is being again taken care here. Is it okay? Wait, I will mute my mic. There is a call. I am back here, right? Ashish, okay. Arpita, right? That assignment, you all people have done it?
Yes, regarding that, there was some confusion doubt. With this.
Okay, in that case, today night at 8 o'clock, arrange session.
Yeah, sure.
Today night, Ashish will arrange a session for all of you. It is on confusion on model-based testing, that is state diagram, stack, and writing test script. Okay?
Yes, sure.
You arrange it. And already video is also there. I think probably you can refer a video also. Have you?
Yes, sir. Sir, it's just a small doubt. If you can
tell me now only.
Clear it out.
Tell me now only.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Sir, the assignment says CTA group activity exercise on writing test script for the given system specification. So we have to write it for the reusable component which is given, or we have to consider our project and then write the test script.
No. Wait 1 minute. I'll get into your Google class.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
1 minute. I have not opened the Google Class, right? I should have kept open. And further, if anything is required, you can arrange. Okay, now let's look into software engineering. Class one.
Yes.
I'll change
Then
the
next if the assignment.
One minute. One minute. Which assignment? Model based one here.
It's nine, sir. Seven.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Yes.
Let's look into that. Yeah. And here, reusable components. Reusable count. I have given here. Video is also there. This is there. CTA group activity exercise on writing test script for the given system specification model. And everything I have given here.
Yes. So we have to consider
this
only. Reusable this component development only. Yeah?
The reusable component, what you do, out of the four project members, two people let them develop a reusable component stack. Other two people develop a test script. Person one, I mean group one, tester, right? Understood, no?
Yeah. Yeah. Yes, sir. Two of them will do the test script and two of them will do the stack.
Yeah, that's what I want to tell. Right?
Yeah.
Anything,
yes.
Anything else?
I've
given a video also description here. Right? Please do this. If you do this one on your own, your learning will be much higher, and this is a part of software testing which we are going to cover in unit number 4, model based testing. Already we are given it, right? Only highlighted things,
yes.
And some theoretical part I'll get into exercises. Thereby we'll complete the unit 3 and unit 4, be ready for unit 5 as a last part of this semester. Got it?
Yes.
Anything else?
So it's not about the project, but there's one more thing.
Tell me.
Sir, there was some students who got a message saying that they need a letter from the parents that they don't have an objection of the college starting from 17th. Is it true or?
No. Okay, whenever I say that one, that will be true. I don't know.
Of course.
Okay, maybe they might, it may take some time for the notice to come to the department. Got it? The moment
okay.
I say that one,
okay.
Start acting on that. Got it?
Sure.
Our principal signature has to be there in the circular. Not oral communication here and there. Right?
Sure. Yeah.
All right. I don't know anything about this so far. Okay. Wait, there are some circulars here. Should not be. Okay. Okay, it is not. Right? It is not. Right? Right. Anything else? Anything else?
No, sir. Nothing else. We can't.
Anybody? Arpita? So what we are doing is, right, in the next class, we'll take a case study. Case study on that architecture, Oracle architecture I told you, no?
Yeah, yes.
I'll take a case study. Please send a message to me. Then we will cover about the agile methods and extreme programming. And remaining all are theoretical things, terms. This part we'll cover. UI design will be covered on Friday. Object-oriented already have covered. Right? And till now what we were speaking is all about this. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Object-oriented, I have done it. If you wanted that one, you let me know. I will call you people extra slot, not in regular slot.
Okay, sir.
Right. Anything else? Otherwise, we'll stop here. This is how we will proceed towards the end of the session. We are in the unit number 3. Right? We'll go through the agile methods in the next class along with the case studies. Okay.
Yes, sir. Is there any Diwali holidays or anything like that? Because we were planning. Archana ma'am said that she might postpone the minor project to next Tuesday. So next Tuesday, is there any holidays or stuff because of Diwali?
Next Tuesday is the 10th of November.
Yes, sir.
Okay, Deepavali is on 14th, 15th, and 16th.
14. Yeah. So is there any
No, no,
for
no.
holiday for that or?
14th will be holiday, hope so. 15th Sunday, 16th maybe. Let's see that one. I'll let you know in the next class because so far we have not received any circular. The moment circular comes, I'll inform, but I'll look at the VTU holiday list and I'll tell you. Okay, in the next class.
Okay, sure. Yeah.
Right. Okay, anything else? Otherwise, shall we stop here now?
Excuse me, sir.
Please.
So the question is regarding that stack assignment, sir.
Okay, tell me.
Sir, there are 9 test cases mentioned in the document, sir.
Yes.
Sir, should we restrict to that 9 cases or can we increase or decrease those cases? Because there were 1 or 2 cases may not be handled correctly. So,
you increase, right? You increase.
No, sir. Not only about increasing, sir, but also can we decrease 1 or 2 because there were 1 or 2 which cannot be handled for the generated stack, sir. So,
No. Okay, that is a minimum number of things you must do. Minimum number of things you must do. Right?
Yes.
Are you getting this?
Yes, sir.
All right, anything else? Anything else? Any question from anybody? And here is a video. You can look into this. And why that is not getting opened, I don't know. But if you look at this, I'll open it and tell you about that. My course samples in where did I keep case study course to be where did I keep not on this what is the title I reusable component. But okay, look into that. Okay, we have mentioned about the writing test script. So when you look at this test case one, this is mandatory. Who has asked that question? Can you come online with me? Unmute?
Yes, sir, it's Dheeraj, sir.
Yeah, Dheeraj. Test case one is mandatory. Test case
yes,
two,
sir.
3, right, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, these are all mandatory.
Sir, I have doubt with test case number 3, sir.
3, okay, let's get into 3. Okay, state is empty. Okay, here, okay, are not added fully. That is a mistake here. Okay, state is empty, string, okay, I mean retrieve. Okay, state number 3. State is empty, then store. Sorry, it is there. Store. Right? When you store it, when you call the method store, when it is empty, you have to check that also whether it is getting stored or not.
Sir, by default, if the stack is empty, integer store function will happen. So there is no.
What is the guarantee? I don't know what code has been written by other party. Will it happen it or not? I have to check it now.
Yes, sir. But in case if it's full, we'll be checking in the full.
It is different. Full behavior is different. When a stack is full, when you call store, it will give error saying that stack is full. But here, it
yes, sir, absolutely, we'll be getting that. Sir. In not empty and not full, also we'll be getting that. We have the space and we can input the integer.
Look at that. When a stack is empty, whether it works correctly or not, you have to check it. When stack is full, the same store will behave different. When stack is empty, store behaves different. Both okay stores are different though the same code is there, right?
Yes, sir, I'll look into that.
You have to look into that, right? So session is getting closed. Any other question? Any other question? So let's stop here now. 44 students at the end. Initially, it was around 50, near 50. Now it is a 44, right? Everyone must attend and make it useful to your learning. So I will end this meeting. Ashish, shall I end the meeting?
Yes, sir. There are no doubts from my side.
Okay.
So, might be.
Right. Okay. Bye. We'll see in the next class, regular class. Right?
Yes.
If any extra class is required for that, let me know. Right? Otherwise, we'll go to the case study on architecture. Right?
Yes, sir.
Right. Okay. Right.